The Philippine Trade Department has recently launched a program aimed at mentoring young Filipino furniture designers. Now, the agency says participants of the program will be trained by the likes of world-renowned Kenneth Cobonpue. Now, here to talk to us more about that is Nelly Dillara of the Philippine Trade and Training Center. Good afternoon, Nelly. Finally, we have you back again on the show in person. Welcome to the Business Roadshow.
Yeah, thank you very much, Stanley, for this opportunity. And it's really, you know, exciting to be back again in person.
In person. Yes. Okay, so you have a lot on your plate right now, one of which is Obra Design Masterclass, which is designed to empower and uplift local talent within the furniture and creative industry in the Philippines. Tell us first about this program.
Yeah, okay. This is actually a three-month program. It starts with training. Training basically focuses on technical and core skills. So technical meaning they will be taught on how to design, how to execute the design and all that. And then the second part will be prototype development. This is in partnership with certain companies who have also committed to be part of the program. So that's where we are sending the mentees to, so that they can produce actual products from the design training session that they have. And finally, in March this year, will be the Philippine, or it will actually be a furniture international show that they'll be participating in. But more than that, we'll also be awarding certain prizes for the best design.
Okay, so we're talking about young designers here. How do they make it to the list? I mean, is this something they can apply for? Is this a grant, or this is a ticketed event perhaps, or they have to pay to be a part of the program? How does that work?
This is actually in support of the Philippine creative industry. So last year, we DTI in particular has actually kicked off a lot of projects, and one of these is the Obra Furniture Masterclass Furniture Design. Okay. So we actually invited industrial design graduates, or not necessarily industrial design, but even those who are interested to go into furniture making, lighting, or even accessories for furniture. So we opened a total of 60 slots for Cebu, Pampanga, and Metro Manila. And this is for free. This is a scholarship program. We invited mentees or mentors who are really, you know, the best of the Philippine furniture industry to become the trainers of this particular 60 mentees. Yeah. And yes, that's actually how we're
going. We premise this interview on Kenneth Cobonpue. Who else is there? Who else is the, well, the big name that a lot of these participants can learn from?
Kenneth Cobonpue, particularly, it's the studio that he has in Cebu, but the ones that are really involved here right now are also the ones who are who learned from Kenneth. But in Metro Manila, we also have some big names. A lot of them are coming from the furniture industry, who has been there as exporters, who had experiences on how to, you know, navigate the export industry. And not only navigating the export industry, but also on the design side. So most of them are actually designers, or designers tapped by the Design Center of the Philippines to also deliver programs to our, not only the furniture industry, but a lot of our crafts and even sectors that would be requiring design.
Okay, execution. So you designed this program to answer specific needs of our young designers. What were the challenges they were facing in terms of making it to the export scene, for instance? Because a lot of Philippine products are really export worthy, but just many designers don't know how to go about that one, in terms of standards and connections even.
Yeah, that's right. So initially, what we really wanted to happen here is to build network with the existing, you know, the enterprises who are composing the resource persons or the mentors for the program. Also networking with the big companies, because eventually they'll be prototyping with the companies. And of course, during the show, we wanted them to get networked with potential buyers internationally. Mm. So those are actually the things that we're looking at right now.
What kinds of talents are you seeing, Nelly, in the Philippines as far as furniture making is concerned? I mean, are we now at par in terms of creativity, in terms of design, with other leading exporting countries for furniture?
That's actually very interesting, because what I gathered from one of the resource persons that we have right now is actually an established exporter, a designer herself, and has also made it big internationally, Europe, and even US market. is that in terms of design capability, they're actually looking at the Philippines as the very source. But I think one of the challenges that's confronting our designers right now is the manufacturing side. Okay. So we have designs, you know, integration of innovation, innovation and creativity, or utilization of the technology is actually one of the challenges that we're confronted with right now. So that's actually what we are also looking at, you know, if we can have a technology, technology that can also support the requirements of our enterprises, particularly the designers, to make them more efficient and more productive in terms of production.
Okay. So the challenge is, on the one hand, you have design and conceptualization. On the other hand, you have the business side.
Yes.
How is your organization helping them, linking them up perhaps with contacts and businesses and enterprises abroad? I mean, we have the mandate from President Marcos to increase our exports. And clearly, this is one of the industries where we can excel.
Yeah, that's right. We're actually looking at, the local companies, or especially the designers right now, in a holistic manner. So we come from the Department of Trade and Industry. Our office is focused on training, technical, functional, and even enabling skills, digital fluency and all that. But in the Department of Trade and Industry, we also have SITEM. We also have Design Center of the Philippines. Okay, so what we're saying is it's actually looking at it on a holistic point of view. So market, even the design, centering of design and all that. But for PTTC in particular, in addition to the training that we have also lined up, we're looking at really supporting them bring their products internationally. So it's a good thing, just to segue, we have another program with the International Trade Center. International Trade Center is actually a joint organization of the World Trade Organization and United Nations. So we were able to develop six training programs on how to export. It covers pro forma invoice, reducing the inefficiency in exporting.
We were just having a discussion a while back with Mona Brea on the taxation affecting MSME. So perhaps this is one of those remedies, perhaps, and changes, in fact, in the way they do business that makes it easier for them to really conduct their business as MSMEs.
Yeah, that's right. We're actually looking at, there has been a number of engagement or even needs analysis or even gaps survey among the enterprises. And one of the things that we really found out is how they go cross-border. Because we've always been saying that once you promote your product on social media right now, it actually gets, potential buyers from other countries. But bringing the products abroad is one challenge in itself. That's why in partnership with ITC, we were able to line up six courses. These are delivered online, but there will be in-person trainers coming from the PTTC. But in addition to that, we also have a number of training programs on exports that's regularly offered by our office, Philippine Trade Training Center.
And for those watching us now, would like to learn more about the training programs at the Philippine Trade Training Center, where can they check them out?
Yeah, pttc.gov.ph, and again, pttc.gov.ph, that's our website, and you can see more than, the OBRA Masterclass, the exports training, but a lot of other trainings that we're offering for our micro, small, medium enterprises, and even the exporters. Thank you.
All right, Nelly Dillera of PTTC, thank you so much for being in the Business Roadshow today. Hope to talk to you again soon.
Sure. Thank you very much. Sure.